I'm Remi Wieten, I'm from Utrecht University in the Netherlands. In second year of my PhD, I'm just going to generally describe my project, the motivation and the background behind my project, and some preliminary results which I've obtained over the first 1.5 years of my project. So generally, my project is about probabilistic decision making. So the starting point which we use is that, well, domain experts are typically more familiar with argumentation-based tools, scenario-based tools, and we want to use those tools to automatically construct probabilistic mathematical models called Bayesian networks. So that's a lot to take in, so I will first go back a little bit. There is a follow-up project of some previous projects in the same area, so I will first describe those projects a little bit before going on. So the background here is, well, like I said, there are domain experts with different backgrounds, so you can think of lawyers and judges who are more familiar with argumentation-based tools, scenario-based tools. And on the other hand, you have forensic experts who interpret, for example, DNA matches, statistical evidence. And then we're used to probabilistic tools such as Bayesian networks. And well, in previous projects, the goal was to understand the relationship between those different normative frameworks for evaluating evidence. And that's mostly because of the number of miscarriages of justice. So lawyers and judges misinterpreted statistical evidence. And that's why people got behind bars innocently. So we try to bridge the communication gap between lawyers and judges on the one hand and forensic actors on the other hand. So we're not familiar with Bayesian network. This is a very simple Bayesian network. So in short, it's a graphical representation of a controlled probability distribution over a set of domain variables. So the domain variables are represented by the controls over here. So in this case, we're interested in whether John is the source of some kind of DNA trace, and well, there's a variable stating that there's a DNA match with John, or there's a variable stating that someone else is the source. And with arcs, you can indicate the relation between those different variables, and it's important to note that those arcs do not mean some kind of inverse relation or some kind of dependency, but it's an independent relationship which the arcs combinedly represent. That's important to take into account. And then for every node, you have to specify some probability table. I won't go into detail which probability you have to specify, but what you can then do is, after specifying the necessary probabilities, you can enter evidence, for example, that there is a DNA match, and you can calculate update probability that John is the source of the actual trace. So it's kind of a sophisticated probability calculator. That's a Bayesian network. So in previous projects, well, it was mostly focused on theoretical aspects of Bayesian network, the connection between normative frameworks. For example, how can you explain the reasoning which happens in a Bayesian network in terms of structured arguments or that kind of research. But in my current research, I'm focused on how do we construct such a Bayesian network. So domain experts, when they have to construct a Bayesian network to use it, they have to typically rely on someone with a mathematical background. So these models are typically difficult to understand. And that construction is very time-consuming and error-prone. And you can think in, for example, police domain. Well, you don't have a lot of time to make decisions, so you want to make a Bayesian network fast. Also, in a dynamic context where the evidence and the reasoning changes dynamically, you don't want to reallocate the variables and the links all the time. So that's also one of the reasons why domain experts revert back to the techniques they're familiar with. So that's the reason why they go back to things as mind maps, Wigmore charts, argument diagrams, scenario-based tools. And the goal now of my project is, how can the benefits of Bayesian networks, so evidence aggregation, sensitivity analysis, all kinds of sophisticated analysis, how can those be exploited in allowing the domain experts to use the tools they are familiar with? So starting out with argumentation-based analysis, how can you build a Bayesian network? So you can split this in three separate research question pilots, pillars. So the first one is how arguments and scenarios actually used in decision making. So experts may use some kind of mind map, but how is that related to more like a formal kind of fragmentation or scenario-based approach? And second question is what I've been focusing on the most up to now. So how can arguments and scenarios actually be used to construct a Bayesian network, which is the most important part. And then afterwards, you can use some kind of argumentation about Bayesian networks. So an expert may disagree about Bayesian networks, some aspects of Bayesian network, and how can you facilitate that process to come to a joint conclusion of what Bayesian networks should actually be. So I will now go into detail on Q2. So two of my supervisors have actually focused on this question before. So if you have an argumentation, scenario-based analysis, this conveys already relationships about variables, uncertainties in the domain between variables. So my supervisor, they proposed a general heuristic for constructing just a graph of the BM, but it's still largely manual. So it's not that useful in practice yet, and I will illustrate what I mean with largely manual. So this is a very simple example. Well, on the left-hand side you have an arguments graph based on structured argumentation. Where from the premise P, you can defeasibly derive Q and then defeasibly derive R. And what the heuristic then describes is that for every propositional on the left-hand side, you create a variable on the right-hand side, which can be in state yes or no. And then for every defeasible inference, you create a simple undirected arc at the moment between the corresponding variables. And here's where the heuristic stops. Because the important parts are formed by setting the arc directions. So depending on how you set the arc directions, different independence relations may be represented. So variables may be independent or not, so it may represent a different situation. And what my supervisor then proposes is that, well, you go back to the domain expert and the mathematical expert, and you consult the domain expert and ask him, well, how do you see the causality in the original argument-based analysis? So is P a cause of Q, or the other way around? And then use that causality to direct the arcs, and then verify the independent relation manually afterwards. So this is time-consuming, of course, and this is, well, it doesn't really solve the problem of automatically constructing a Bayesian network. So what I looked at in my first paper is whether, well, some configuration of arc directions are desirable or not over the other. So here you see, well, you can direct the arcs in four possible directions in this BM, and one is clearly different. And it's surprising that the one on the bottom right is clearly different, and that has to do with that it's a V structure. And that has to do with some algorithmic or computational background that if such a V structure is formed, then P and R are independent in this case. So if you compare it to the original argument graph, you see, well, should they be independent? Well, I believe not, because you can make a difference from P to Q to R. So what I propose, among other things, of course, in larger argument diagrams and maybe network, you have to take a lot more into account. This is just one possible refinement. I would say excludes the bottom one on the bottom right. Because it's undesirable, it does not represent the arguments in the right way. So what I looked at is just argument structures without attack relations. And this is, of course, a limitation. So what I did in recent research was actually focus on an entirely different approach. So note that I just mentioned that, well, my supervisors stated that after constructing just a skeleton of a Bayesian network without the arc directions, they go back to the main expert consults how the arc should be directed using the notion of causality as a guiding principle. But actually, there are argument diagrams where you can indicate whether a used inference or a rule is, in fact, evidential or causal. So, for example, the E represents that P1 is evidence for Q1, while that C between P1 and R represents that Q1 causes R. And what I then looked at is what if you direct the arcs in the BM in the same direction. So for the evidential rules, you point it from the conclusion to the antecedent, and the other way around for the causal rules. And then look at, well, what kind of independence relation does it represent, and does it make any sense? So it turns out that the represented independence relation in this case is the correct representation of the original arguments. I can't go into detail, of course, because it's, well, there's a lot of nuances behind, of course, and about 1 minute to a conference in a week. more difficult because they also depend on your interpretation of what an argument means. So if you have an inference on p to q, does that mean that q given p is very high, or does it mean it should be simply higher than 0.5 or whatever? It's more difficult to interpret probabilistic constraints. So that's really a subject for future research. And I will talk a little bit more about Q3. So if you have constructed a VN, maybe starting out with arguments, but also you can just start out just from scratch, building a Bayesian network, there still can be disagreement between accurate, which relations, which variables to include, which probabilities to be chosen. And what we want to do is develop some kind of argumentation-based support system to help experts resolve conflicts. So you can look at this from two positions. So what I'm looking into now is how are these kind of discussions, how do they take place in practice, actually. So at the Dutch Forensic Institute, the experts typically develop Bayesian networks. So I want to see, well, if there's disagreement, how can you model this, for example, in argumentation schemes? And how can you resolve conflicts? And the other one is computational techniques. For example, say you have a set of arguments about a Bayesian network, and an argument is not justified, so can you then calculate what the impact is of that argument being rejected on the final answer, for example, that say a suspect is guilty or not, or whatever you're interested in at the moment. Okay, so let me go. This is a kind of concluding slide about my current research. So look at the formal relations between mind maps, which are a very informal way of graphing out evidence, which you